traveling sessions, and today we were lucky to travel to western Pamir mountains in Tajikistan near Khorog city. The river I am showing you right now is called Shokhdara. So we are now sitting just in the valley of this river. You can see the mountains, and of course I can guess that you know that we are here for some cool reptiles. So what I have to say, there are not so many reptiles and amphibian species in this area. There are only 9 of them. So among amphibians, we found only one roadkill of Buphotis viridis, and according to the literature, there is one species of green frogs, Rana ridibunda or Pelophilax ridibundus, according to modern classification, but we didn't find it. I have to mention that we are here in the end of September, and frankly saying, it's not the best time for reptiles here. We were lucky to see 2 juveniles of Vipera lebetiana. Yeah, but I didn't catch them. Yeah, they were pretty fast. We found a skin of the same species. It is about 60 centimeters long, so it's quite big animal. And we found several places with Himalayan agamas, Agama Himalayana. Of course, we were not able to catch adults because they sit on very high rocks, and they readily escape as soon as they see anybody. This is the place where adult Himalayan agamas live. It's almost vertical rock, and they easily move up and down, and it's almost impossible to catch them. I can show only some photos. Yeah. So that is where they normally live. Yeah, I tried to climb up and to catch them from the opposite side, but it makes no sense since they readily escape to the opposite side of the rock, and I usually finish with nothing. Yeah, but this is their habitat. Juveniles live in a little bit different biotopes. We have captured one small juvenile. It has now stressed coloration near the throat. Normal coloration for juveniles is bright yellow with orange. You can see it on the photos. Yeah, and now we release our... Yeah. Go. Yeah. Good luck, man. Or woman. And of course, there is Natrix tessellata here. Yeah, and we found also a couple of individuals, one near the river and one also on the road, killed, unfortunately. Climate here is very continental, especially here in the end of September. In the night, temperature goes down to plus 10, plus 8 degrees Celsius. At the daytime, when the sun appears in the sky, the temperature goes up to plus 29, plus 28 degrees Celsius. Today is a little bit colder. It's like plus 25, plus 24, but still the rocks are quite warm. Yeah, and even if not being on their activity peak, some reptiles still try to bask. I'm talking about Himalayan agamas first of all. Yeah, and of course some juveniles of different colubers, different vipers also try to bask, but they don't go very far from their shelters, and it's almost impossible to catch them this time. I'm sitting now at the elevation of 2,400 to 2,500 meters above sea level. Yeah, and just look at these marvelous views. Yeah, so This is a typical biotope for Vipera lebetiana. Yeah, of course, it sometimes goes to the lower elevations, sometimes to the fields, sometimes even to the river, the same as different colubrids, because they are able to climb up on the trees, trying to catch different small birds. Yeah, so this is the typical biotope of Vipera lebetiana. We have a lot of rocks that are available for basking. The same biotope is shared with Himalayan agamas. You can see the rocks. So guys, stay with us, subscribe to our YouTube channel, subscribe to our Facebook page, and remember that it is always better to do responsible herpetoculture and to know more about your species, to know more about natural habitat of your species, and to share this information among each other. Goodbye, have fun, and do responsible herpetoculture.